Yo-Yo says, huh? Oh. Our Bandit friends again. Yo-Yo says, Goose! Hurry! I don't know why, but the monster soldiers are coming by the waves. Yeah, I've noticed. You came to help us? Chris says. Not really. I came to help these two. Oh, it's what's-her-name? And her mother. Philly? I forgot the mother's name. But then the situation turned and we came under attack, says Goose. Shirley says, we came to run away. Here they come, says Goose. Chris says, we need to destroy the globe that's just over there. Over where? Shirley says, I heard about that from Huck. Destroying the globe may do something about the monsters. Well, there's no turning back now. Leave these guys to us. Goose says, you're just too easy. Let's go, says Shirley. Arrgh, say the bandits. Wow, these guys are professionals now. Goose says, oh well, we'll take care of this. Hurry and go and destroy the globe or whatever. Leave this place to us. I can't go past him to talk to the others. Who ran this way? Well, we came from this way, right? Or no? Oh, there's, yeah, Philly and her mother. When I was picking herbs, I met Morrison, who was on his way to Castle Rudo. I begged him to take us with him. I didn't know what was happening. But we can help, too. My mother's medicine is very effective. If you got injured in the battle, please let us know. We'll heal you. Would you like to take the medicine? Yes. Okay, thank you, says Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo and the others took Riz's special medicine. They were healed completely. That's her name, Riz. Everyone, keep up the good work. Sweet. Thank you, but not now. You already healed us to full. Including magic. Sweet. And, Riz. I came here because Philly asked me to, but now I'm glad I came. Our knowledge found some good use. If you need my medicine, you can have it too. It's probably the same. If you need my medicine, just tell us. So I'm guessing we only go the stairs. Just checking to make sure there's no door that we can't see, especially there. Okay, so we've got ways up. Try this way. Oh! Durzel says, the observatory is just beyond. Revas should be there waiting. Don't screw it up. Here's our friends. Goose says, this is hard. Shirley says, let's go up there. Okay, Apego and Ness, defend the landing on the stairs. Nura and Kanta, defend the top of the stairs. Arrgh! I don't know why they yell Arrgh. Why not Avengers Assemble or something? Shirley says, you guys are the path of hope that the Moonlight Witch left, right? That's what Huck was saying. Hurry and go. We won't let any of them get through to the observatory. Goose says, there's no turning back now. Got it? Arrgh! Here they come! Sweet. Well, I want to talk to them before we go in. Shirley says, don't worry. We won't let any of them get through to the observatory. I said, don't worry. Kanta says, I'm not going to goof up anymore. If a monster climbs up here, I'll kick them back down. Good to know. Nura says, don't worry. The defense here is strong. Apego says, we're working for free again. I'm guessing these two just say the same thing. G So cute. Ness says, hurry and go destroy the globe or whatever. Hey, that's what Lodi said. Not Lodi. Sorry, Lodi. I called Goose Lodi. Beat up any monster that comes in. Beat him up, I tell you. We still go that way, I'm curious. Yeah. Alright, let's go to the observatory. Oops, I ran into you. Sounds like a good time to put a save in. Revas's voice says, yes, come this way. Yeah, I want to come this way. What's wrong? Are you scared? I said muhaha. Where's the globe of doom? We can only go forward. Okay. Behold the globe. Ooh. Looks like it's got veins and a heart pumping. What do you think? I think it's grotesque. Feel its heartbeat. The globe has a countless number of consciousnesses contained within. Now it's an object, but it's alive, and it has grown to its maximum potential. My fully armed and operational Death Star. You are too late. I don't have to do anything anymore. The ceremony is complete. Now all I have to do is wait for the wave of Raual to appear in the world. No, says Yurio. Why did you do such a thing? Asked Urzel. It's interesting to watch you be destroyed without knowing why. But I'll respect your efforts to guess this far, and I'll tell you. This is to save our world, the world that you refer to as another world. The Witch's Island that floats in the Witch's Sea, that's what you think it is, but actually, that's not true. There is no island there, just a rift in space. The two worlds are connected there, and that's the only place where you can get back and forth between the two worlds. There are people that live in another world, living just like people of this world. The people's lives in another world are threatened by the wave of Raual. We realized that 30 years ago. The people of our world were able to use spells since birth, but that brought tragedy upon us. The negative will that was not digested each time spells were used accumulated and became a monster that couldn't be controlled. That is the wave of Raual. Dursel says, you think it's right to destroy our world to save yours? We debated over and over in our world, too. Some of us came over to this world to see if that was allowed or not. They walked this world with their own feet. Yurio says, that's the witch's pilgrimage. Really? With Yurio catching on quick, I didn't even gleam that. That's right. Among those who traveled, there were some people who left advice so as not to create the wills of despair in the world. But we already had our conclusion. We decided to cast the wave of Raual from our world to this world to save our own world. Stella says, you sealed the wills of despair in the globe to create the same condition that gave birth to the wave of Raual and to guide it here, huh? That's right. The wave of Raual is attracted to the same wills of despair that made it grow. If this world has more wills of despair than our own world, the wave will come to this world without fail. That's why we needed to be heartless and cold. The people of my world had to cast out any will of despair in order to succeed. Do you understand now? Chris says, was there no way? No way to save both worlds? No, there was no way to do that. No, as far as I know, there was no way. Just answer the same question like twice, but in different ways. Yo-Yo says, then there might be a way? Anything is possible, but we had no time. Huh. So he's not just a completely evil, like, I want to destroy the world just because. He actually has a motivation. I mean, he's still evil, but, you know, is a little more nuanced. I'm sorry, but I can't have you destroy the globe to foil my plans. Well, you were acting total muhahaha. Now you're just... You're trying to save your world, but... Yeah. The means don't justify the end, I guess? Or the end doesn't justify the means? I will have to have you people die here. Here I come! Okay! We'll trash you. Vandon Revas? Oh, so these are Vandons, okay. They're pretty cool looking, little flame dudes. Should we get rid of the Vandons first, or should we hit him first? Wait, we're like situated differently. Okay, let's hit Vandon C. Stella can do a finishing move. She'll do the finishing move on him. Durzo will attack D because it's closer to him. Flame burst from Revas. Ow. How much are they hitting us for? It's only gonna hit him, right? Yeah. And not for much. She probably would have done more damage to him just hitting him normally. Vandon C. We have a La Recure, which heals a large amount of damage for all allies. Since we're all damaged, we'll cast that on all friends. I like the way it says that. I don't think I've ever cast that before. And then Stella. Yeah, we're trying to get rid of one of the Vandons at least. And he was hitting D. Actually, he's got his finishing move. Believe it or not, I'm gonna use it on the Vandon, not the big baddie. Oh, he missed. Rather lame of you, sir. Okay, we got rid of one of the Vandons. Let's heal everybody. Oh, it didn't even do that much. I thought I was gonna heal more than that. Oh no, that's the healing. Never mind. So what was the other thing? I thought that was her. Okay, we've got two Vandons left. Brave Rush. I'm gonna start with Revas though. I'll have the other ones hit Vandon A here. Except Durzel can't hit it. Have Durzel hit Revas. He's out of the range of the other one. Okay, good. We got one Vandon left. Oh, he's just running past it. Girls will hit this one. Flame burst. I'm gonna have use this again. La Ricure. It's French, you see. A fireball. Oh boy. And Stella. Vandon. Oh, that's what it was. One of the Vandons moving. It was probably healing somebody. Take this. Yo-ho. Oh, we killed Revas? We'll just run up to it. Only Dirzel can hit it. Well, it's closer now. There you go. Wow. Look at that fill up. Oh my god. Stella, 42. Dirzel, 42. Yo-Yo, 42. And Chris, 42. And we're still going. Okay, we got angel food and a full mind potion. Yeah, I can't move. Ah! Woof, says Revas. Let me guess. You're about to show us your final form. Ha! Ha ha ha. You did well to beat me. But this victory is the last one you'll get. How will you stop the wave of Raual? It's almost here. Ha! Ha! Oh, what the hell? He turned to stone and... What? Why did he turn to stone like that? Is that just how he dies normally? Dirzel says, okay, we're going to destroy the globe. Yo-Yo says, okay. Chris says, we have to remove that icky stuff that surrounds the globe before we do that. Stella says, I'll use my bombs on it. Okay. Sticky stuff, huh? No way, says Chris. The bombs had no effect, Stella says. Lodi says, what's wrong? The clouds are really looking dangerous now. Lodi, says Yo-Yo. Chris says, oh, Alf, and Mr. Morrison. Alf says, I can't believe both Morrison and I were following you without realizing we both were. I ran into him on the way here. I was really surprised. Yo-Yo says, we need to destroy the globe, but the bombs didn't work on it. What? The bombs were useless? Morrison says, the globe that matured is probably protected by some psychic shield. I don't think physical attacks alone can do damage. Alright, magic then. Is there any way around this? Alf says. We need something that does physical as well as psychic damage. Lodi says, like the Crimson Fires? Oh, yes, that's right. Well, do we have any of that? The explosion of the Crimson Fires is said to have effects on purifying the psyche. The Crimson Fires should work well. Yo-Yo says, oh, I think we still have the Crimson Fires that Lodi's grandfather Kevin gave us. Really? Says Lodi. Let me see. This, says Yo-Yo. It's a Crimson Fire, no mistake about it. But it's too small. We need something about the same size as what I used against Galga. Morrison says, it's not over yet. We can use a spell to make it grow. I think I can't do it alone. That's a weird way of saying it. But with Ms. Chris's help, we can make it bigger. You did not just say that. You dirty old man. Stella says, I can use some spell too. I'll help. Let's try it, says Chris. Chris, you don't know what you're getting into. Morrison, Chris, and Stella sent magic power to the Crimson Fire. Crimson Fire got bigger and bigger as it absorbed the power from the three. You notice the other two are female. I know I'm going a little too far with this double entendre here. Oh. Is that big enough? Yo-Yo says, wow. Okay, says Morrison. That should be enough. Here you go. Stella took the Crimson Fire. So now she's going to throw it like a bomb? I'm going to throw it. Well, yes, that's the answer to that. Please step back. It can be dangerous. You didn't tell us to step back when you threw your bombs. Goose's voice says, wait! Let me do it. You only have one shot, right? Leave it to me. I won't miss. Trust me. What? You think Stella will miss? Stella nodded and gave the crimson fire to Goose. Why? Stella's good at throwing bombs. It's just throwing it like a bomb. Whatever. Okay, I'm kind of nervous. Here it goes. Awesome. Oh. So, okay, they destroyed the icky stuff, quote unquote, around the globe, and there's the globe itself. Yurio says, we did it! Thurzo says, okay, Yurio, it's your turn. Aim for the globe with your silver dagger. Okay. Don't miss, says Goose. Sure. Aim true, Yurio! Go! Haha, sweet. Ugh. Ooh, look like purple slugs flying out. Chris says, what was that? Morrison says, those are the souls trapped within the globe. They've been released, along with the wills of despair. Yurio says, then King Rudolph and all those soldiers that headed to the border with no expression are going to turn back to normal? Hopefully. It looks like they're turned back to normal for the time being, says Morrison. Huck yells, stop! Darn! Too late! Chris says, huh? Let me guess, we just released the wave by doing that? Uncle! Yurio says, bad at. Now that we all know who each other are. Excuse me, says Huck. I guess it's empty inside. Yurio says, yeah? Chris says, we did just as you told us. Yurio says, we removed all the stuff on the surface and then stamped it with the silver dagger. Yeah, that was fine, but I found out something new about the wave of Raual at the ruins of Godona. Something new, says Chris? There was another way if the globe was still left, but it's okay. I'll explain later. Now we must hurry. The power that calls to the wave of Raual is still there. Explain now, mister. Dursel says, the Queen. Queen Isabel is still around somewhere. Huck says, because of the nature of the ceremony, I don't think she's too far away from here. The psychic power won't reach the globe if she's too far away. Let's look for her, says Stella. Okay, says Yurio. Yurio and friends formed a party. Dursel says, let's split up and look for her. We have to prevent the wave of Raual from coming to this world no matter what. We just formed a party, now we're splitting up. Huck says, the Queen must be continuing with her spell to call to the wave of Raual from somewhere. We have to stop her. Wow. Excuse me. I'll talk to them. Goose says, I've made a decision. I'm going to demand some reward money from King Rudolph after this is over. He better give me about 30 million pyrs or something to make it even. Man, all we get is bad luck hanging around you. Bad at says, the color of the sky is turning weird. We're gonna be in trouble if we don't hurry. Lodi says, Master Dursel, I have something to ask of you if we succeed in this mission. Sure, as long as you're alive then. I'll make sure I'm alive. Now, let's go find the Queen and end this thing. What does he want to ask? Alf says, we have to find the Queen first. And Morrison? You don't have any time to waste, he says. Okay, can we now walk around these areas? Well, there's nothing there anyway. Oh. Shirley says, I'm glad. You're okay. What happened? I didn't explore that chamber yet. Oh, I hope there wasn't anything important in there. Like, besides the globe and our friends. Tirasweel says, uh-oh. Like, I was gonna look around in there some more. It looks like the whole building is weakened by the shock when the globe fell. Are you okay? Says Chris. Yeah, says Yurio. Are you stuck? Says Shirla. Goose says, yo, Shirla, we're okay. Alf says, all the people inside are okay. You guys go and look for the queen. We'll catch up. Find the queen, says Huck. That's the last chance to stop the wave of Raual. Morrison says, Yurio and everyone, please go on. We don't have any time left. Lodi says, don't mind us. I'm more worried about the wave of Raual. Go on ahead. Badat says, we can move all these rocks out of the way. Don't worry. Shirla says, everyone, attention. We have to clear the path. Ready. Arg. Now. Leave this to us. Go and find the queen. I don't know where she is. It's get cleared in no time with this many people. Leave this to us and go find the queen. Apego says, heave, heave. Ong, ong. Oh. 1-2, 1-2. Boss, are you okay? Says Kanta. Dig, dig. So where's the queen? We have to go back inside? Yeah, heal us. Awesome. Something about being healed completely. Yeah, I guess we're going back in. Alright, we're going to be going back in. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.